Great to have you with us here on The Cafe. Now, as managing editor of Your Home and Garden and also Taste Magazine, she knows a thing or two about good home design and food. Now, as a judge last year, she's come back to co-host for season 5 of The Block NZ Girls vs Boys. Welcome, Shelley Ferguson.
Thank you. Thank you, Mike. Lovely. Thank you, Mel.
Yeah, now, this is your second time co-hosting, isn't it? And you were the judge the time before.
Correct.
Oh, God, it all goes so fast, doesn't it? Are you enjoying the co-hosting role?
I'm absolutely loving it. I think as a judge, you just walked into that room. You didn't know what had gone on that week, what the personalities behind the decor decisions were, and now I'm just involved in the action. I see what goes on, and I feel like I know the teams and I can see exactly what their style is and how they execute it, so it's really fun.
Okay, speaking of the teams, Dills and Dills.
Yes.
Hilarious. Are they really that dramatic or are they just having a laugh?
They're really that dramatic. That's what I like about them. They're completely honest. They're not afraid to just completely be themselves and throw it all out there. They're really, really passionate about what they're doing.
Passion is good.
Passion is good.
Although, Dills and Dills with an S and a Z doesn't work on television. Can we just like to say that?
Yeah, that's why we've gone to Big Dills and Dills Junior. Right. Hoping it'll make it a bit easier for people.
They're both quite big, though. I mean,
yes,
they're, you know, have you seen their muscles?
Yes, yes, no, I've noticed that.
You don't want to do a muscle off with them. They're huge.
You do not want to be at the gym with those boys. They both also have tats, which...
Yeah, does anyone not have tats on the show? I also wanted to ask that question.
I will find out for you.
Yeah, because I think they've pretty much all most likely got them.
There's a lot going on.
Great. A little game I play of things like that. They've got a tattoo. Oh, good, I'll just take that piece of chocolate and eat it.
No, they are all great personalities this year, and decisions have been made. Like, do you think Dills and Dills will ever get over losing house number 3?
I'm not sure they will.
Right.
They took it pretty hard, didn't they? And you could see the whole thing change, because they are teams. They're not couples. So there was a real social dynamic before that and a real banter. You know, it was almost like they were getting to know their friends and hanging out together. And
then
now it's just a competition, and you can see that coming across.
You know what they need to do? They need to practice mindfulness.
Yes, they do. Send them a book.
Breathe through it.
I'll read Dr. Chantel's book.
Yeah. Now, I don't know if you can answer this, but what house, if you walked into the block, what have you chosen?
Ooh. Mm. There's a couple of
different Because of your history, you'd pick well. So what
would
you pick?
Absolutely. I look for natural light and a good outlook. So Sam and Emmett's has that. But I also look for a functional and a practical space, because I've got a family and I want room for my family to move, and I want an outdoor zone. So Nikki and Tiff's also has a really good corner patch of land. Mm. But the fact is they're all quite close together. They're all on the same site. So they all share a lot of the same benefits, which is really, really good. I don't think anybody has a dog of a house or is going to lose out.
Right, that's a very diplomatic answer.
It's funny when you're watching it too, because I was watching it for the first time going, oh, I wouldn't want that house, 3 floors. You've got kids, you're not going to want them on the separate floors. You're going to want them with you if they're little kids. You've got small children.
Yes.
And you edit 2 magazines.
Yes.
And you do the co-host of The Block. How do you do the juggling thing? How does it all work?
Mindfulness
and a lot of balls up in the air.
A lot of balls in the air. I have really fantastic family support. So my husband is a bit of a legend at the moment. He's not quite working full time, so he's taking up a bit of the slack. But then he works evenings, so we sort of tag team it and I go home and do the evenings. So it's just all about setting up that structure and support, I think, before you start something like The Block.
Yeah.
Because otherwise, you know what it's like being a mum.
Have that discussion. I'm going to be this busy for
exactly.
this long, and then we'll have a holiday.
Yes. Plan.
And you two are very similar, because you're the only girls in the family, aren't you?
Oh,
yes.
Yeah. Surrounded by boys.
Surrounded by boys. Yes. Speaking of boys, I don't know why I've got this, Shelley, but I've just written down here on my notes, builder for house number 1 with a little smiley face next to it. I don't even know what that means.
Oh, neither do I.
I don't know. Why would I have done that? I'm not sure.
I don't know. Have you seen him and do you think he's hot?
Yeah, maybe. Well, I think that's what it is. No, because you were initially, before The Bachelor was on TV, you set up The Bachelor for Clio magazine.
Yes, I did.
Back in the days. Mm-hmm. So do you think any of these builders potentially could be next year's Bachelor?
Oh, well, we saw Marty, didn't we? He was a bit of a hot favourite.
Yes, he was a hot favourite.
Yeah, and I think builders just have that that lovely Kiwi ingenuity and that DIY thing about them.
At the end of the day, you've got an auction that'll be live on TV. We've got quite a few rooms to get through on the block. Do you think he's a leader at the moment?
Oh,
you probably can't answer that, but...
you know, they had a practice run, which was great, in House 5, and I think that was a real bonus because they got to see, they've only got a week. The amount that they do is phenomenal. They have to plan, they have to project manage, they have to shop, they have to design, they have to build. And it was really interesting to see how they also planned to get a really good result that the judges felt was strong. So I think the judges... It's just key, isn't it, what they're going to think. So they're all going, how am I going to stick to my big picture and create a house that suits my style? And how am I going to meet the brief each week so I make the coin?
Oh, goodness, it's such a lot to think about, but I'm sure it'll be very exciting. So, Shelley, you've got something to do. Go and check out for the tattoos for me, if you will.
I will.
And check out House Builder number one as well. It's been a pleasure having you in here. Thank you so much for coming in. And we look forward to seeing how things progress on The Block NZ, Sunday 7 p.m. and Monday to Wednesday at 7:30 on TV3.